Welcome to Books and Company. I'm your host, Alberto Rios, and we're joined today by science fiction writer and educator Paul Cook, who's talking about his book, most recent book, Karma Commandos. Paul, welcome.
Hi.
We've been having a good conversation, and I really want to follow up with something you were saying off camera about how is a book written? You wrote this book in a very interesting way.
Well, my last three novels, this includes Karma Commandos. The way I write is when I get a basic idea is, and I don't know where I thought of this, but I get a roll of fax paper.
So an actual roll.
An actual roll.
So it's the old scroll.
Well, it's a scroll. You roll it out, and then I usually have it on a separate desk, and then I get three different colored pens. And then I'll write, well, this is going to happen in the beginning, and then this is going to happen here, and then this is going to happen here. And it'll be different sets of characters, and so, you know, green might be the main character and blue might be the secondary character, and, you know, yellow is the bad guy or whoever, whatever. And so I can see it'll be like a sine wave. And I can make sure that however long I dwell on one, that I don't dwell too long in one area, and then I can move along and I can just see it paced. And I remember, as I was mentioning earlier on the show, that I'd learned to do this from the old Tom Swift Jr. novels that my mom got me when I was sick, because those were written, we now know the term, it's an arc, a dramatic arc, and the arc doesn't go all the way down, it only stops part way, and then you get new to chapter two, and it goes up, and it goes like that, so it never reaches closure, and that's what I learned to do that. So all of my chapters would have that sense of openness. Something would be concluded, but something needed next to be dealt with. And so I'd have the fax paper. And of course, if you screw up, then you can just take scissors and get rid of that and then tape it.
Like old film.
Old film.
Splicing.
And then you get to see it. And then the thing, when I wrote Halo, the scroll was 51 feet long.
Oh, 51 feet.
Yeah, 51 feet. Well, because it's a longer book and it has many different sets of characters and different things happen. But when all was said and done, it was just like this, you know, sacred scroll. It was all scribbled and whatever. But yeah, it ended up being that long. Yeah,
it's a great idea. It's got to adorn the top of the Paul Cook archives, right?
Well, the idea I got from the way you write screenplays, according to some, is through note cards, and you would put them on a, you know, like a cork board. And if you see like Saturday Night Live, they'll have each of the skits will just be a single card. And so they can have the whole show plotted out. Okay. Well, I just simply took that and just made it linear. But I originally started 30 years ago with different colored note cards. And I just decided when they invented fax machines, I said, hey, this is great. You roll it out and there it is. So
it's funny. You were also, that description, the way you're describing it, is almost like musical composition too. I mean, that they all have to sound good together. And so you're describing kind of musical progression.
It gives you kind of like a view of 30,000 feet of your novel. You know, it's like, it's okay, because you can see what's going to happen. Now, you know, I just recently bought a Nook.
Okay.
And you can scroll one page at a time, but you can't like, you go way ahead or way back. You can't do what you can do with a physical book. So with the scroll laid out like this, you can see where things happen or where things are supposed to happen, and you get a visual sense of where you're headed. And I do know some novels are kind of written open-endedly. My committee chairman at the University of Utah, he was one of these open-ended guys. He said, you just sit down and you start. And I said, well, like, where are you going? You know, it's like, said, I'm not going to take a trip if I don't know where I'm going. You know, but that's the difference, I think, between mainstream literature and genre fiction, is that you have a different set of goals in mind.
Well, that is an interesting distinction.
And you do read them with different, you know, mindsets. You know, like maybe it's just okay to be kind of open-ended, and that's fine if it's John Irving or whatever. But, you know, with science fiction, only anymore science fiction is written in series and trilogies, and so many books don't end, and I can't write that way. See, that's, I cannot write a trilogy, I cannot write a series, because of Philip K. Dick. He was the one I read the most and studied when I was younger, and he never wrote a trilogy, he never wrote a series. All of his books were like symphonies, they came to an end. And that's what I do in my books. A good book of poems is the same way. it's what Robert Frost said, right. Is you have a collection of 24 poems, the 25th is the book.
Right. And it's, you feel it. Mm-hmm. You aim for that and you know it.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a something, you know, it's nothing worse, I think, on TV than you get to the end of your hour, you've put a lot of time into it, and it's to be continued.
Yeah.
Ah!
Yeah. Well, I just finished reading a giant book by Dan Simons called Ilium, and it's 1,000 pages long, and it has no ending.
Okay.
And it turns out there's a sequel called Olympos, and it's that thick. And I'm not going to read it. I'm just not going to read it. I just, you know.
We'll get a letter from him.
I know. He's a Facebook friend. He's a nice guy, actually. So, but it, and he's a wonderful writer. But it was just the way.
Yeah.
Because of money, because of selling things. And,
I understand that. Yeah. There's some marketing kind
but
of finds its way.
I can't do that to the reader. You can't.
Yeah.
Readers are precious. It's a privilege to have readers,
mm-hmm.
and you don't want to cheat them or mm-hmm. say, "I fooled you. You have to buy another one."
Mm-hmm. Come back for dessert tomorrow.
Yeah, come back. Yeah.